What's up, man? What's up? Back with another album review. And I've been looking forward to this album. I didn't know it was about to drop because, like, people just dropping stuff out of nowhere. Like, you never know when R&B artists are. I don't even know what genre you would consider the Weeknd. But never mind that. Let's just get on into it. Let's get on into the album review. And Don FM, I'm gonna show y'all something that I put in my Facebook group for the podcast, and I'm gonna talk to y'all about the reviews it got and who got picked or whatever. It's something that we play in the Facebook group a lot, and it's called One Gotta Go. And these are the artists who I put up there, and I'm gonna tell y'all who was perceived that had to go. Who had to go? Let's go. So y'all see the four. It was Chris Brown, it was Miguel, it was Bruno Mars, and it was The Weeknd. So I didn't know this album was about to drop though. And I appreciate what The Weeknd has created. I appreciate the mixtape run he had, the trilogy he had early in his career. I appreciate the records that he wrote for Drake. I appreciate the music that he created, but a lot of people, like 70% out of the 100 comments said that The Weeknd gotta go. It was either The Weeknd or Miguel that people were saying gotta go. So they basically was giving Chris Brown and Bruno Mars a pass though. But my perspective, y'all might get in the comment section to tell me what y'all think about this though. But my perception, I think Bruno Mars gotta go because I prefer like The Weeknd music. I prefer Miguel. I think Miguel is underrated. He one of the GOATs. And Chris Brown, he is just undeniable about Chris Brown, though. But let's go get on into it, man, and listen to some of these records and review this album. Let's go ahead and go.
Grind time. Grind time.
So his last album is called Scurry Hours. No, After Hours. I'm tripping. I'm getting it mixed up with Drake. It was called After Hours in 2020. Now he came out with Don FM. Know what I'm saying? He just won a plethora of awards. He performed at the Super Bowl. You know what I'm saying? The Weeknd been doing big things. Real talk. But let's get on into the first record and see what he's talking about.
The Trevor Jackson Podcast.
Listening to 103.5 Don FM. You've been in the dark for way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms. Scared? Don't worry. We'll be there to hold your hand and guide you through this painless transition. But what's the rush? Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5.
Hey, I just got to reading a little bit of the, whatever this is, the bio of this, and like, it say now you're listening to 103.5 Don FM. You've been in the dark for way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms. First record. Let's go. Gasoline.
It's 5 a.m. my time again. I've soaking up the moon. Can't sleep. my time again. I'm calling and you know it's me. I'm pushing myself further, I'm just trying to feel my heartbeat beat. I wrap my hands around your neck, you love it when I always squeeze. It's 5 a.m, I'm high again, and you can see that I'm in pain. I've fallen into emptiness, I want you cause we're both insane. I'm staring into the abyss, I'm looking at myself.
That record threw me for a loop early. He on his weirdo vibes, man. He on his real weirdo vibes now. The Weeknd, come on now. And my light died. My little bright light, my little colorful light died, but it don't matter though. We still reviewing the album, creating the vibes. Gasoline. What genre of music is The Weeknd? Is it alternative? Is it R&B? Is it, what is it? Y'all tell me. What type of, is it just, I don't know what it is, but let's get to it. How do I make love? How do I, what is this called? How do I make you love me?
We're going back in time. I'd like to see you try unpacking thoughts through tunnels in your mind. I'll fix you mushroom tea and cross the restless sea. Release yourself to escape reality. It doesn't faze you. I need a breakthrough. I only want what's right in front of me. It's quite unusual. Seeking approval, begging for it desperately.
Me personally, I have an appreciation for big records, like when it actually takes skill to put it together. Cause like nowadays we don't hear much of that. We don't hear big budget records. We hear like quick thrown together records where the beat ain't even tracked out. They just uploaded the beat and the person sung, rapped, whatever they did to it, it's mixed and mastered and it's shipped out right quick. Now when I listen to this record, I have an appreciation for big records. That's what I'm saying. Like, if you understand what I'm saying, where the engineer had to put it together, the drummer came in, the guitars came in, the person playing the instruments came in, and they tracked it out. You know what I'm saying? Each instrument is tracked out. Each vocal is tracked out. It's just big. It sound arena ready. It sound big. I have an appreciation for that, no matter what they're talking about. That's just me, though. Take My Breath, that's the next record, number 4. It's long, too, like. Most of the time when we hear records, they be radio ready, and they be 2 minutes and 30 seconds or 3 minutes. This Take My Breath record is 5:39. Let's see what it is for it to be so long. I get it now. Like, I understand when people say that the record industry is in a dark place and people have to sell their soul to become part of it or be down with certain things or whatever. This is chant music. It sounds kind of demonic. It sounds very dark, and it sounds like he's conjuring up spirits. That's just me, though. You know what I'm saying? That's just me. But the record is flawless. Can't hate on the record, but I'm just telling you what I heard. Next record, Sacrifice. Listen to the titles too.
I was born in a city where the winter nights don't ever sleep. So this life's always with me. The ice inside my veins will never be. Find that missing piece. When you cry and say you miss me, I'll lie and tell you that I'll never leave. But always sacrificed your love for more of the night. I try to put up a fight.
Jackson Podcast.
The Weeknd stand alone. Like, I just showed y'all that one gotta go situation or whatever. The Weeknd stand alone. Like, the quality of music, he's in a bracket of his own. He's not making music like nobody else. He don't sound like nobody else. Like Bruno Mars and I forgot homeboy name who he just did the collaboration album with. They took it back to that 70s funk type sound. The Weeknd ain't taking shit back. This is his style, his swag. This is what he's on. This is the place, the space that he's in. He creating his own music. It's big, it's bold, it's powerful. And I appreciate it. Let's get on to the next record. A Tale by Quincy.
Looking back now, I didn't know what it was supposed to be. And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I just did the best thing I could with them because they know well I loved them. But I did do the best I could. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't. I will never forget watching my mother get put in a straitjacket and taken out of my home when I was only 7 years old. She was diagnosed with dementia praecox and put in a mental institution, leaving my daddy along with me and my little brother Lloyd. I later had an evil stepmother.
So this is just a skit. I wish I would have knew that before I played it. It's just a skit by Quincy Jones. That's cool though, because Quincy, he legendary. Like, I remember DJ Khaled said that. No, Fat Joe said that DJ Khaled is the new Quincy Jones. Boy, that was so disrespectful to me. That was big old cap. That was real disrespectful to consider DJ Khaled the new Quincy Jones. Fat Joe should have been. They want to counsel people for talking about the LGBTQ community. They should have counseled DJ Khaled for that. Out of time, the next record. Let's go. Same beat.
Remember when I held you, you begged me with your drowning eyes to stay.
No cap. We made it to track number 7, and that's the hit. I heard, like, y'all know my ear for this music thing now. I heard that's a smash. A smash. Y'all go listen to it and tell me if that's a smash or not. Out of Time, that's a smash. Real spill. Here we go again. It's the next record. Look, I can't even get off that Out of Time. My iPad won't even let me change the record. Change the record, bitch. I was waiting on the breakdown. I was going to play it till it broke down, but it never broke down. To me, when I'm listening to that record, that sound like I'm riding in the Batmobile through Gotham City. That's what it sound like to me, personally. That's a smash record, though, but I was waiting on the breakdown. Let's see if it broke down yet. Still ain't broke down. I be needing that bass, man. What y'all think about that? Do y'all be needing that bass? Next record, Best Friends, though. Let's go. No bass again. Of toxic cloud, it tore us apart. Things you want, I'm not looking for. You're my best friend now. You're my best friend now. Oh, I don't want to be responsible for your heart if we fall. Cause I'll get clumsy and tear it apart. I love you so, but we can't get close. You're my best friend now. You're my best friend now. Oh, I love it when we climb, and I will never burn you. I like that record. I don't know if that's a smash or not, though. But you want me to tell you something? Like, I appreciate the production and the arrangement and the engineering so much on this album that looking at Apple Music, you know what I'm saying, right now, I'm kind of pissed off that Apple Music don't have credits. Like, streaming services, Tidal is the only one that show the credits of the production team, the engineers, the sample. It shows the credits of the album. And that's something that I used to appreciate back in the days when CDs was out. When we was doing CDs and looking at CDs, I used to have to open it up and get my nerd in my nerd bag and see who was who. You know what I mean? I wonder how, if you're an engineer or a content creator, tell me how you feel about that. Like, they don't have the credits on these streaming services no more. Is that messing with y'all bag too? But we're going to get into the next record. Is There Someone Else? Let's go. I don't know how it is at R&B. I'm going to stop it, though, right there. I don't know, like, this might not be R&B, whatever type of music he making, or he might be just a super big artist. But 2022, we ain't got time for the beat to play for 45 seconds before you say something. For real. And if you're an artist out there listening to that, you need to take that in consideration when you making music. We ain't got time for that. So we're going on to the next record. And I'm going to make this the last record because I don't want to play the whole album so y'all can go listen to it for yourselves. And I'm going to grade it at the end. Every Angel is terrifying.
Cried out. fear me among the angels' order. Even if they pressed me against their heart.
That was too spooky. You know what I mean? Make me want to hop up in the mystery van and go solve the situation with Scooby-Doo and the Scooby Snacks. You know what I'm saying? That was a little bit too spooky for me. You know what I mean? That dark music and that stuff, whatever time he on right now, you need to go heal yourself, my brother. That record was too spooky. But that's what we're going to end it off with, man. I appreciate y'all tuning in. Go check out the Weeknd album. I can't grade it right now. I can't grade it. I'll be capping. I got to listen to it again, relaxed in the whip, just cooling. But thank y'all for tuning in. I'm out, man. Let's go.
Grind time. Grind time.